A really warm day at Whistler, and one of the most grueling events in the Winter Olympics was about to take place. The men's 30-kilometer pursuit, 15 kilometers classic style, and another 15 kilometers freestyle. The favorite, Petter Northug, the reigning world champion. From Sweden, Marcus Hellner, who'd started fast in the 15 kilometers event, but then run out of gas. And away they went on the challenge sometimes called the skiathlon. 8 laps of the course, a total of 30 kilometers on heavy snow and temperatures of 11 degrees Celsius. Of the 61 starters, 8 would retire, including Martin Kukal of the Czech Republic, a former world champion. And Switzerland's Dario Cologna was one of the early leaders. Cologna, the impressive winner of the opening race, the 15 kilometers freestyle. Behind him, the strong Czech Lukas Bauer and Jean-Marc Gaya of France. A quarter of the race gone and no breakaway yet, still Cologna looking for his second gold ahead of Bauer, who was especially strong in classic style. Then came Gaya and Alexander Legkov of Russia. Getting back to the front, Bauer, but now also at the front, number 16, Johan OLSSON of Sweden, and number 41, George Gray of Canada. Petter Northug, the world champion, biding his time in 12th place. 37 minutes gone, and Lukas Bauer, the number one in the overall World Cup standings 2 years earlier, with Johan OLSSON on his tail, onto one of the faster sections of the course. And coming towards the transition, the halfway point, it was 32-year-old Lukas Bauer from the Czech Republic, at the head of the line with plenty of skiers tucked in right behind him. Now they would change their classic skis and poles for the freestyle equipment. Bauer, but no sign of Northug, who had changed next to him. Dario Cologna clipping in, Marcus Hellner just arriving. Cologna on his way again, Northug now swapping skis as Bauer set off once more. But it was OLSSON who was quickest through the transition, ahead of the Czech and the Swiss. And Johan OLSSON tried to make a break. The Swedish team had talked about this tactic before the race, and the other Swedes content to let OLSSON go on a solitary quest for the gold medal. Leading the following pack was Bauer and Alexander Legkov, then Dario Cologna. 1 hour gone, and OLSSON was out on his own. Had he gone too fast, too early though? Time would tell. There was still a long way to go. But Johan OLSSON would certainly make the rest sweat. As the warm sun blazed down, he was blazing a trail, extending the gap to 25 seconds. In the group behind him, two more Swedes now, Hellner and Daniel Richardson, number 14, battling up the steep slope. But still a score or more, with hopes of a gold medal. Less than 4 kilometers to go, and the fight back had begun. Legkov with Anders Zerdegren, the fourth member of the Swedish team, then Angerer of Germany, and Marcus Hellner. OLSSON pushing on, but the gap was closing. The Russian, Alexander Legkov, with Tobias Angerer, and behind them, number one, Petter Northug of Norway, the world champion, was making a move ahead of Hellner. Legkov going well on the uphill slope. He'd finished back in 37th place in Turin, but he was looking menacing now. And there was no question that OLSSON was being hunted down. The 29-year-old Swede had been on his own for more than 8 kilometers, but 4 skiers were pushing hard and closing in on him, slowly but surely. One of them, though, would fall back. Petter Northug, the Norwegian, broke a ski pole, and he would struggle home in 11th place. Eventually, OLSSON fell back into the clutches of the hunters, and Russia's Alexander Legkov trying to demoralize him by overtaking. But OLSSON would not relinquish the lead easily. And after a grueling 30 kilometers, it still looked like being a close finish with 4 men in at the death. And now it was a mental fight as well as a physical one. Johan OLSSON and Marcus Hellner, number 2, the 2 Swedes, Legkov, the Russian, and Germany's Tobias Angerer. Taking the tricky downhill bend for one last time, OLSSON going wide and Marcus Hellner taking over the lead. Hellner, the man who'd been quickest in the early stages of the 15-kilometer race, only to blow up towards the end. He'd lost 20 seconds in the last 4 kilometers, but this time he was looking strong, skipping around the final curve into the stadium. Angerer now in second place with OLSSON back in third, but Hellner with the finish in sight, the glance over his shoulder telling him he was safe and the celebrations could begin. Marcus Hellner had won the Olympic pursuit. Tobias Angerer in second place. Johan Olsen coming third. Lucas Bauer, the early leader, back in seventh place. Angerer completely exhausted. And Petter Northug, the world champion and World Cup leader, arriving looking despondent. He'd won bronze in the sprint, but he'd been back in 41st in the 15-kilometer individual, and now he finished outside the top 10 in the pursuit. But the winner, 24-year-old Marcus HELLNER. He'd only ever won one World Cup race, the 15-kilometer free, the previous season, and now he had an Olympic title. Tobias Angerer of Germany taking silver. The bronze going to Johan Olsen, who said he knew his lead of 25 seconds was never going to be enough, but who refused to give up. And Sweden had two men on the podium.